What's up, Sherry here from No Fucks Given Crew. How's it going? All my beautiful soul sisters and soul brothers. This is going to be a divine masculine reading for March the 18th until the 25th. Whoa. Okay, so I am going to do a Celtic wing spread for you. I'm going to be using John Holland's Psychic Tarot for the main energy, and then my cards for clarifiers. So just give these a quick shuffle. So I'll do the Celtic wing, which is 11 cards, 3 clarifiers for each position, and then a feminine and masculine energy on either side. Stop. All right. Okay. For the divine masculine, present position. 9 of Pentacles, harvest, abundance, grounding, firm foundation, wealth, accomplishment. You're coming in with, feeling very accomplished, like you have something to offer the divine feminine. 3 cards, 4 of Swords, 10 of Pentacles. Wow, right off the bat, 4 of Wands. So 2 fours, grounded energy, very grounded. And same thing with the 10 of Pentacles here. So again, another 9 is nearing the completion of a cycle. The next card up is the 10, which he got. All right, so the 4 of Swords. This is retreat. It is healing, rejuvenation. It is masculine energy being represented here. So there's a sense that he has retreated from negative people, negative situations, negative energy. And he's really doing some soul searching and healing at the present moment. And this card also talks about laying a foundation in the 3D world. So it seems to me like he got these cards in the twin flame reading. My apologies, I do so many readings, it's hard to remember what happens in each one of them. The 4 of Swords, healing, retreat, a pause. The 10 of Pentacles. Again, it's one card up from this 9. So he has this ultimate vision of the 10 of Pentacles as his achievement, his goal, his dream, along with this 4 of Wands. So the 10 of Pentacles is that moment of retirement. It is that final resting place. You've worked your entire life, built up a wealth, and now you're reaping the abundance from it, but you don't have to put a lot of energy into, into your finances. You've already saved up enough money to retire, and now you're just enjoying life. You have your grandchildren around you, or family and friends, and it's a restful period. All of this represents rest, harvest, achievement, arrival. So the 10 is, it reduces to 1, so it's a completion, and a new beginning as well. So the 4 of Swords, or sorry, 4 of Wands is my twin flame calling card. It is, again, the arrival, it's harvest, it's making your dreams realized. It could represent buying a new home, travel, engagement, marriage. But it is the completion and then a beginning. So it's like that feeling when you buy a new house, you feel like you arrived, but yet, which is a completion, but yet you're beginning because you got this entire life ahead of you to enjoy. So while he's in this meditative, restful, peaceful state, he's grounded and he's thinking of his future and how to manifest this 10 of Pentacles and the 4 of Wands. But right now he feels very connected to the divine feminine. You are his passion, his desire, his end goal. Okay, for the foundation, wow, Four of Wands, again, same card, Twin Flame calling card, 1111. And it's the foundation, and this says foundation and achievements. So it is such a beautiful grounded energy. From the Four of Wands arose this grand vision and need for, you know, manifesting it, making it happen. So I'll pull four cards for that. You know, maybe I'll just read the John Holland description to you since we got it twice. All right. This card confirms that you've been what you've been building is now firmly established with a strong and solid foundation. You deserve this. It's time for you to harvest the rewards for your efforts. What you sowed, you can now reap. What you've received, be open to receive as you worked hard and have given so much. Allow the universe to give a little back to you, for there has to be an even exchange of giving and receiving in order to prime the pump of gratitude and reinforce the law of attraction. Using the more traditional meaning in this card represents a period for celebration, peace, prosperity. It may also imply marriage or buying of land or a new home. As you enjoy this time of relaxation that you so deserve, know that nothing remains stagnant and the winds of change are always knocking at your door. Wow, Ten of Cups, Two of Wands. Oh my God. Take a good, long, hard look at those cards. That is beautiful. He got the 1111 calling card. With the 1111 calling card. With the 1111 calling card. I've never seen all three of these pop up like this, so close together. So on top of that, he got the Ten of Cups. This is the happily ever after. It is emotional bliss, harmony, peace, arrival, completion, beginning. Two of Wands is making a decision in the past that wasn't based on fear. It was based on your highest goals and dreams. And so seeds of intention were thrown out into the universe by the masculine. And now that he's waiting for that energy to return. And what is that energy? That twin flame connection. So this is the foundation. So that means he feels this way and he's growing from that seed. He's feeling abundant. His future is just on fire. Wow. And so I made this card to replace this card. Because I wanted to try to keep the original meaning for this card. In terms of accomplishment, arrival. I replaced it with this one. But this one more just is a confirmation that this is a twin flame connection, hands down, no question. So, wow, I'm just blown away here. Okay, so his recent past position, solitude, not surprised, the hermit. So he is still in that state of hermetism, but it is a calm, peaceful stillness where the hermit is about detaching from society. You're going out, you're leaving it all behind. No more money, no more possessions. That's it, I'm done. I'm going to find myself, find that light within. Search for wisdom and knowledge so that you can share that with others. So yeah, this is more just a silence. And there's still some healing involved here with this card. But this card is like, it's a major pilgrimage. You know, complete shutdown, cut off from everyone, everything, in order to really, truly find yourself. Wow. King of Wands, Page of Cups, and the Four of Cups. King of Wands. A couple of weeks ago, he was the Divine Masculine, you, was showing up as the King of Wands. This is a center of the sun. It is coming into your full power, your full strength, and making your dreams manifest, making them a reality. But also being a leader, and it is achievement. The knight is a forward movement towards that goal, whereas the king has achieved. He is the pinnacle of achievement, arrival. The page of cups is a messenger. He wants to express his love for his divine feminine. And so this is a beginning of love. It is the idea of moving forward with a loving relationship, but it has more to do with communication, opening your heart, allowing that love to come in, and then wanting to express it and share it and exchange love. The Four of Cups is stagnation. You know, things aren't moving fast enough. It also means that you did not accept the cup of love from your divine feminine and instead turned your back on her. Even though you wanted to communicate your feelings for her, you needed to withdraw in order to do that soul growth, which you did. You're now showing up as the King of Wands. Well, that's the past position. So I'm interested to see what you're being represented as now. So, yeah, this is all male imagery here. So I'm believing that, you know, this Four of Cups does come from the masculine in that he's turning away from love in order to heal himself. So this is a feminine energy for the hermit. So maybe you are presenting that book of wisdom, that spiritual wisdom, to the masculine, and then allowing him to take that information and do his own, research. All right, so for your outcome that you desire and likely to get if you stay on your current path, I just want to move these over a bit. Wow, intuition, High Priestess. So I like to see this card as the Divine Feminine popping into the reading to say that I am here with you always in the 5D. The High Priestess is one that goes within and listens to her inner knowing to guide her. She is psychically intuitive, connected to the collective consciousness, and she is always with you in the 5D. Every twin or every person on earth and in the universe has a twin. There is no specific count of twins on earth. I know there's a rumor out there that says that, you know, there's only a couple hundred thousand twins. How is that even possible? A twin is the other half of your soul. There's no special group of people that have twins. When you are ready, when you've done your soul growth, when you've come to a state of conscious awareness, then your twin will show himself or herself. Okay, there's nobody that is more special, more gifted than anyone else out there. We're all the same. So his end goal, what he desires, is to be with his divine feminine and have that soul connection. Sorry. Okay, so I'm going to pull three cards for that. Nine of Cups, wish granted. The King of Swords, and the Five of Wands. Okay, so the Nine of Cups, wish granted, wish fulfilled. What you desire will come to fruition, and it has to do with emotional abundance, emotional satisfaction. Your cup is overflowing with love. So he got the 10 as a foundation. So it's like he's working towards that goal. He's waiting for this moment for either himself to walk through that door, you know, towards, you know, into this warm, glowing home with the crackling fire. Or, you know, he's waiting for his twin to come towards him. But either way, wish will be granted. And plus, she is always with you in the 5D, regardless. The King of Swords is clarity of thought. He is authority. He is unemotional. He's detached from his emotions. He doesn't allow his emotions to control his decisions. So all sword suit is communication and thought. So he wants to communicate how he feels, how this connection, you know, opens his heart chakra and makes him feel abundant in love. He wants his wish to be fulfilled, and it will be. And, you know, this could represent an air sign. The Five of Wands is competition. It is rivalry, but it's meant to make your light shine brighter. So he feels that there are obstacles and challenges that he must overcome in order to be able to speak his truth to the Divine Feminine. But ultimately, that this is what he wants to do. Like I said, there's a small obstacle that needs to be overcome first. There's a little bump in the road. Not a biggie. Okay, so for the crossroads position. Nice. Oh my God. That is so beautiful. You guys are awesome. So this is a lover's card. Twin flame union. But this is the longing for union, wanting it. It is not actual union. I consider the Two of Cups to be more of the spiritual union card. And the Temperance card is integration of the souls. So this is, you know, feeling a divine connection with your twin flame and wanting to be with her. Seven of Cups, not sure how to get there. Or is it an illusion? Ace of Pentacles and the Moon. All right, so you are questioning whether or not this connection is real, a true twin flame connection. So the Seven of Cups is having too many choices, you know, wondering if it's an illusion, a dream, fantasy, and just not knowing how to get there. She's, you know, feeling a bit like Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz. This could represent the feminine energy, since there is a feminine being represented here. But it's, you know, confusion. A stall. Then we have this gift being presented to you from the universe. Or this could be the masculine, since it's a masculine hand, offering a new beginning to his divine feminine, wanting that start in the 3D, grounding this energy, you know, into reality, making it happen. Then we have the Moon card, which is very similar energy to this, in that there are some things that are not known. There's half-truths being told. But this also represents, you know, going through the dark night of the soul, releasing those final fears, those things that are holding you back from really going forward and beginning this new life with your Divine Feminine. So this also talks about using your intuition, your inner voice, your inner knowing, in order to guide you through that darkness. The Moon also represents the feminine energy, while the Sun is the masculine. So what I'm getting here is that he wants to find his way through the darkness to his light, to his love. And Spirit is offering you this brand new beginning, this Ace of Pentacles. So what you do with it is up to you. Will you take the key and move bravely through the darkness? Okay, what are you resisting? Ace of Swords, another ace. Triumphant success. This is clarity of thought, cutting through the darkness, cutting through the barriers, and making a decision to move forward. But you're resisting this. Why? Another one. This is Wheel of Fortune. Okay. Eight of Swords. All right. We got the Three of Pentacles. So, you know, there's a sense that he really wants to make this a thing in the 3D with the Three of Pentacles here. And it is happening. There's the Wheel of Change is really stirring things up in his external environment and in his internal environment. So this is good luck, good fortune, karma's on your side. Again, significant changes, a completion of a cycle that could last from 5 to 10 years. But it is going to happen whether you want it or not. The Eight of Swords is a self-imposed prison of the mind. Feeling like you're being held back, unable to move forward because of a decision or an oppressive force keeping you down from the external environment. But it's all an illusion. You can use this sword to cut through that darkness, release yourself from this mental prison if you like. The Three of Pentacles is laying a solid foundation, a beginning in the 3D, and feeling achievement as a result of it and continuing to work forward to the future. But this is all in the resisting position. You're resisting that change. You're resisting releasing yourself from that mental prison and resisting really grounding that energy in the 3D. But you hold the sword of truth. You have the power to release yourself. Okay, for your internal environment, wow, judgment, truth. It's a grand awakening. It is a rebirth. It is letting go of all of those stories, those lies, those attachments, egoic and material possessions, and realizing that the truth below all of that is you, your spirit, your authenticity, your living your true life, your highest purpose, your highest calling, and stripping away all of that noise. So this is the phoenix rising from the ashes. You know, it's like you're taking the sword and cutting away the darkness and freeing yourself and rising from the ashes as this powerful awakened soul who is aware, you know, of their mission. Their mission is to be free and be themselves and love. So this card also represents significant changes taking place in your environment, and a decision needs to be made. So you're being asked to evaluate, weigh your decision very carefully, because it has far-reaching consequences. Eight of Cups, Eight of Pentacles, and the Knight of Cups. So the Eight of Cups talks about leaving negativity. It is a pilgrimage. It is finally deciding to walk away from emotional abuse. You know, someone is controlling you using your emotions, your heart. And this is that moment when you decide enough is enough. True love doesn't feel this way. True love doesn't want to hurt you. So there's a movement forward, a decision. I'm done with this darkness. I know my truth is out there. And I'm going to find it. I'm going to live it. Then the Eight of Pentacles is one card less than this one. So internally, you feel accomplished. You feel, you know, like you've built up a beautiful life for yourself in the 3D, and you're continuing to work towards it. So there's a sense that you have the ability to free yourself and start a new life, you know, an independent life, free of emotional abuse, free of the ego. And then we have the Knight of Cups. This is a knight in shining armor who wants to express his love, move forward with that expression that you had in the recent past. So there's a sense that you came into your power, and now you want to move forward with that. But the Knight of Cups is also a longing, a yearning for union. The relationship isn't established as of yet. It is a gesture. It is a want. It is a movement towards that love. So it seems to me like you've gone through a major awakening process. You realize that material possessions and staying in a situation that isn't healthy is not what's important to you. What's important to you is love, and how love makes you feel, and wanting to hold on to that love. So yeah, I'm getting a real movement forward with these cards. So Spirit is asking you to move forward. It is time. Okay, so for the external environment, Seven of Swords. The Divine Masculine got this in his reading last week. So it's an external environment. So there's this sense that, you know, somebody in your environment is going to deceive you, isn't telling you the truth, is lying to you. You don't have all the answers. There's confusion, darkness, negative thoughts. But you have the key to free yourself from that. Five of Cups, Three of Wands, and Magician. Five of Cups is emotional loss. It is a grieving. It is, you know, you feel that someone's deceiving you, hurting you, and causing you a lot of emotional pain. But this pain only shows itself when you have an attachment to somebody or something. And when that thing leaves, that's when the loss is felt. But there's a sense that, you know, it's a movement away from this emotional abuse. Someone in your environment is making you feel this way, and you want to escape. So the Three of Wands is the card right before the Four of Wands. And remember, you got the Two of Wands in your recent past. So the Two of Wands, you're waiting for that return. You're waiting for an energy to come forth so you can walk out that door, or the feminine can walk through towards you. And here we got the Three of Wands. That's that return, that energy coming towards you. So it's a sense of accomplishment, achievement. You've received a little bit of that energy in order to, you know, continue to push you forward. So you feel accomplished in terms of your dreams, your goals, your higher purpose, making that a reality. And then we have the Magician. And this is the master manifester. He's able to make his dreams manifested into the reality, into 3D. And so there's a real sense that, you know, in his external environment, he's moving away, using the sword to cut away this negative energy. And as a result, he's feeling successful about it, which is giving him that energy and drive to really continue to make his reality the way he sees fit, not the way somebody else is interpreting it or making him feel. Does that make sense? He feels that he is being deceived, by somebody in his external environment, and he's realizing what the truth is. Six of Swords. Just what the card says, moving on. Same kind of energy as the Eight of Cups. Both masculine, both moving towards the light. This is emotional, this is mental. So again, it is making that decision finally to cut away the darkness, release yourself from the mental prison. Even though you're resisting it, this is going to be your final action. The wheel of change cannot be stopped. So this is your freedom. Good for you. So I love this card. You can see the darkness. He's moving towards the light. It's that final moment, walking out that door towards your destiny. Six of Cups. The Queen of Swords. And Two of Pentacles. Okay, Six of Cups, reunion, someone from your past coming back, or perhaps this is you, masculine, thinking about someone from your past who makes you feel love, an innocent, pure love. And there's a sense that this energy is coming back to you, or you may be moving towards it, towards her. And then we have the Queen of Swords. This is clarity of thought. Remember, you got the King of Swords up here in an outcome that you desire. So it's expressing your truth, your love, in a spiritual way, because we got that connected with the High Priestess. So what you're asking for is clarity of thought and communication regarding your divine feminine, and what you will receive is clarity of thought and communication from your divine feminine. She's being represented as the Queen of Swords, somebody who sees through the darkness, sees through the bullshit. She holds a sword of truth. She is truth. You are moving towards the truth, towards love, towards purity. The Two of Pentacles is a decision that needs to be made. And this card talks about, communication. Whenever my throat gets scratchy, that's what it has to do with, communication. And here we have the Queen of Swords. But anyway, back to this. This is the wind of change. The only thing that's certain is change. So you can really feel, you know, the wind being stirred up and movement forward, especially with that Wheel of Fortune at the base. Lots of energy, lots of movement forward, and Spirit is asking you to bend with the wind, be flexible, and allow. Okay, so for the summary outcome, the Fool, new beginnings, taking that leap of faith towards your destiny. Wow. It's a brand new beginning. It is, making that decision to take a leap of faith. And seeing the world through a child's eyes, innocence, no expectations, no attachment to a final outcome, just taking that leap of faith and seeing where it takes you. So that this is the summary of the entire reading, is that you would like to move forward, take that step, and ultimately you do. You do choose to walk through that darkness into the light. Towards love, 3D. Nice. Whoa. Okay, Queen of Pentacles. So making shit happen in the 3D material world. She's the 3D queen. So she represents harvest, abundance, you know, having a life that you can feel, touch in the 3D, not just a 5D connection, as the High Priestess represents. It is an actual physical form. She also represents being open and sharing, and drawing people to her because of her kindness, her love, and her generosity. But it is a 3D grounded energy. So here, the masculine, you would like to take that leap of faith and move towards your divine feminine in the 3D. And looks like you will decide to do that. Here is the feminine again, popping in and saying, I am with you always. And in the 5D, even though I'm not with you in the 3D, I'm here. I'm connected to you always. And you are safe. Then we got the universe card. We got this in the twin flame reading. And so this is completion. Major cycle completed. Done. The end of the fool's journey can take up to 20 years, and then a new beginning. What comes after the world card or universe card is the fool's card again. Major cycles of completion. And for the final outcome. Nice. Oh my God. That's awesome. Ace of Cups. Love begins. And I just love how it's pouring down on you guys. Look at that. Being brave, taking that leap of faith. And where is it going to lead you? True love. Unconditional love. It was worth that, you know, treacherous voyage through goblin forests. So this card only comes when you're ready to accept love into your life. Open your heart. You've let go of the past. You've forgiven people. You've healed your heart. And now you're coming together to share that love. Nice. Fool card again. Oh my God, the Knight of Wands and the Six of Pentacles. So, Fool card once again, looking at life through a child's eyes, new beginning, taking that leap of faith, getting on your horse of fire as the King of Wands and riding off into the sunset, you know, towards your destiny. It's a forward-directed energy, but it's a fast movement. Taking that leap of faith, getting on your horse and going for it. Nothing stopping you. I want this love in my life. I deserve to be happy. I deserve to feel love. No more bullshit. And the Six of Pentacles is that even exchange between the two of you in the 3D. So there's a sense of sharing a life together in the 3D. Being open to sharing a life with your feminine in the 3D. Wow. What a perfect freaking ending. Okay. So let me just pause it there. I'm going to rearrange the cards and then I'll pull the feminine and masculine energies. I'm so excited about this reading. Oh my God, you guys, this is awesome. You know, I know the feminines right now, their heart is broken. They're going through a grieving process, a final release. And, you know, if there's any doubt in your mind that's causing these feelings to creep up on you, don't doubt, because look at this beautiful spread here. I cannot make this shit up. All right, so let me just pause it there for a moment. I will see you in a second. I'm back. Okay, so I forgot to look at the bottom of the deck, so I'm just going to give this a quick shuffle for the overall energy of the reading. Okay. I'm guided to look at this card. Nice. Heart chakra. Yes. Shared energy between the divine feminine and masculine. Heart chakra is activated. Put that right up there beside the Ace of Cups. No. Darn it. Ah, stay there. Okay. So I'm going to pull four cards for the feminine, four for the masculine, and I'm going to use the Osho Zen Tarot. Okay, starting with the feminine, the energy, her external environment is Nine of Swords, sorrow. So the external environment could represent the divine masculine, feeling trapped, caged, behind this bar of thoughts. This card talks about staying up at night, unable to sleep, consumed with worry, anxiety, fear. But it's a nine, which represents a completion of feeling this way. Okay, for the external environment, for the masculine, Hangman, new vision. So seeing things from a different perspective, and this could be the feminine energy. Seeing you, or seeing, allowing you to see things from a higher perspective. This represents change. New vision, beautiful. Okay, so for the feminine's internal environment, the outsider, Five of Pentacles. Feeling locked behind this gate. Unable to move forward, but the gate, the lock isn't latched. It is unlocked, so all you need to do is just unchain yourself and walk through that gate. So there's a sense that you feel alone, left out. Nice, integration. This is a union card. Internal environment for you, masculine, is integration. I'm going to read this to you. And I will read the Five of Pentacles as well for the feminine. The image of integration in the Unio Mystica, the fusion of opposites. This is a time of communication between the previously experienced dualities of life. Rather than night opposing day, day suppressing light, they work together to create a unified whole, turning endlessly one into the other, each containing in its deepest core the seed of the opposite. The eagle and the swan are both beings of light and majesty. The eagle is the embodiment of power and aloneness. The swan is the embodiment of space and purity, gently floating and diving upon and within the element of emotions, entirely content and complete within her perfection and beauty. We are the union of the eagle and the swan, male and female, fire and water, life and death. The card of integration is the symbol of self-creation, new life, and mystical union, otherwise known as alchemy. A small child in this card is standing on the side of a gate, looking through it. He is so small and so convinced that he cannot get through. He cannot see that the chain holding the gate is not locked. All he has to do is open it. Whenever we feel left out or excluded, it brings up these feelings of being a small, helpless child. It is not surprising, as the feeling is deeply rooted in the earliest childhood experiences. The problem is that because it is so deeply rooted, it plays over and over again, like a tape in our lives. You have an opportunity now to stop the tape, to quit tormenting yourself with ideas that you are somehow not enough to be accepted and included. Recognize that the roots of these feelings in the past and let go of the old pain. It will bring you clarity to see how you can open the gate and enter that which you most long to become. Okay, next is going to be the feminine, her hopes and dreams, or hopes and fears, sorry. The rebel, the divine masculine, twin flame. I will read that also. So I was waiting for you to be presented as a divine masculine. Here you are, the King of Wands in the recent past position, and you've now stepped into your fullest divinity, your true authentic self. So I'm seeing this as the feminine's hope. The powerful and authoritative figure in this card is clearly the master of his own destiny. On his shoulder, he has an emblem of the sun, and the torch he holds in his right hand symbolizes the light of his own hard-won truth. Whether he is wealthy or poor, the rebel is really an emperor because he has broken the chains of society, repressive conditioning, and opinions. He has formed himself by embracing all the colors of the rainbow, emerging from the dark and formless roots of the unconscious, past and growing wings to fly into the sky. How beautiful. His very way of being is rebellious, not because he is fighting against anybody or anything, but because he has discovered his own truth, his own true nature, and is determined to live in accordance with it. The eagle is his spirit animal, a messenger between earth and sky. The rebel challenges us to be courageous enough to take responsibility for who we are and live our true life. The divine feminine is rooting you on, cheering for you, watching you step into your power as the divine masculine. Okay, the divine masculine, hopes and fears. Three of Pentacles, guidance. This talks about being guided by spirit, but also using your internal knowing to guide you. So since I read that rebel, I will go ahead and read this card. The angelic figure with rainbow-colored wings on this card represents the guide that each of us carries within. Note that they're both growing wings. Like the second figure in the background, we may sometimes be a little reluctant to trust this guide when it comes to us, because we are so accustomed to taking our cues from the outside rather than from the inside. The truth of your own deepest being is trying to show you where to go right now. And when this card appears, it means you can trust the inner guidance you're being given. It speaks in whispers, and sometimes we can hesitate, not knowing if we have understood rightly. But the indications are clear. In following the inner guide, you will feel more whole, more integrated, as if you're moving outward from the very center of your being. If you go with it, this beam of light will carry you exactly where you need to go. Integration. And it's like, you know, he's coming into his spirit, like, you know, really finding his soul and allowing that to guide him. But it also, I'm also picking up that this is a feminine energy that is guiding him, guiding you. Okay, so for the final outcome, nice, consciousness. Oh my God. So this was the crowning energy, I believe, for the twin flame reading. So I read it already. So this is making that decision to cut away the darkness and find complete stillness within your mind. It is an arrival of consciousness, stillness, knowing. And that's what I'm really picking up with the reading, you know, with the Queen of Swords up here. You are not forcing your masculine to make changes in order to suit your needs. You're standing there with the sword of truth, unwavering, in your knowing. And from that, you, the divine masculine, are attracted to that beam of light, that knowing, that truth. And ultimately, you seek the same. Final outcome for the masculine. Nice. Ten of Pentacles. It is what you wanted. Present position, you got the Ten of Pentacles and the Four of Wands. And this will be your final outcome. Ten of Pentacles. We are the world. So I'll read that to you. Lots of pentacle action. Humanity is depicted here as a rainbow of beings dancing around the mandala of the earth with their hands joined together in joy and gratitude for the gift of life. This card represents a time of communication, of sharing the riches that each of us brings to the whole. There is no clinging here, no grasping. It is a circle without fear, a feeling of inferiority or superiority. We recognize the common source of our humanity, the common origins of our dreams and longing, our hopes and fears. We are able to see that we are all joined together in this great miracle of existence. When we can combine our tremendous inner wealth to create a treasure of love and wisdom that is available to all, we are linked together in this exquisite pattern of eternal creation. Wow, that is a powerful card to end with. Okay, so now I'm going to pull two cards from Call It Fair and Read, Enchanted Map, and I will read those as final messages from the universe. Okay, I just want to make sure I don't have them upside down. So beginning with the Divine Feminine Compass, that's beautiful, and education for you. Okay, 50, so that's kind of what I was saying with, you know, the Queen of Swords. You are pointing your compass to true north. You're an unwavering. You know the truth within. As long as you orient your compass to true north, the direction of your higher power, you will never be lost. You're entering uncharted territories right now and can expect wonderful new experiences. To stay on your highest path or destiny, you'll need to keep your compass pointed to true north. Only spirit or higher power can serve this function. Money, prosperity, prestige, romance, and other material achievements can't help you find your true path. They are simply things you may experience along your journey. Know that spirit is working in your life, so even if you feel lost temporarily, it will be easy to find your way. Have faith and trust, for your compass with spirit as true north will ensure that you'll never be lost again, even in the starless night when all seems dark. Very reminiscent of the twin flame reading I just did. You know, looking up and seeing yourself in the universe. In the universe guiding you. Okay, so education. Life is filled with lessons. Be teachable. Wisdom comes from participating in life, not just reading about it. This card suggests that you might not have enough knowledge about what you seek, the direction to take, your circumstances, or the nature of your inquiry. Important information is coming. Now is the time to go to school, ask a person who might know more than you do, or find a teacher or course of study so that you can more clearly understand what the next right action must be. Sometimes life unexpectedly sends you to an unfamiliar school, and you must learn by experience. Now is the time to be teachable, open to changing your preconceived notions. Be a student, and be willing to state the most powerful mantra of all, I don't know yet. That doesn't make any sense. But that's okay, because it's okay not to know. Let me know if this reading resonated. I love reading your comments. Thank you guys so much for all of the support that you give to me. It means the world to me. And if you would like to order a reading, my email is in the description box below. All right, love you. Peace.